Good day and welcome to the Bilibili third quarter 2024 financial results and business updates conference call. Today's conference is being recorded. At this time, I'd like to turn the conference over to Juliet Yang, Executive Director of Investor Relations. Please go ahead.
Thank you, operator. During this call, we'll discuss our business outlook and make forward-looking statements. These comments are based on our predictions and expectations as of today. Actual events or results could differ materially from those mentioned in today's news release and in this discussion due to a number of risks and uncertainties, including those mentioned in our most recent filing with SEC and Hong Kong Stock Exchange. The non-GAAP financial measure we provide are for comparison purpose only. The definition of this measure and a reconciliation table are available in the news release we issued earlier today. As a reminder, this conference is being recorded. In addition, an investor presentation and a webcast replay of this conference call will be available on the Bilibili IR website at ir.bilibili.com. Joining us today from Bilibili Senior Management are Mr. Rui Chen, Chairman of the Board and Chief Executive Officer, Ms. Collie Lee, Vice Chairwoman of the Board and Chief Operating Officer, and Mr. Sam Fan, Chief Financial Officer. I will now turn the call to Mr. Chen.
Thank you, Juliet, and thank you, everyone, for participating in our third quarter 2024 conference call to discuss our financial and operating results. I'm pleased to deliver today's opening remarks. The third quarter of 2024 was a landmark quarter for Bilibili. We are excited to share that we achieved our first quarterly adjusted net profit while setting new records across our community metrics. These milestones are a strong testament to our ability to deliver profitable growth and the unique community value that we continue to unlock. Looking at our financials in more detail, total revenues in the third quarter accelerated, rising by 26% year over year, reaching RMB 7.3 billion. Driven by our successful diversification into the strategy game genre, games revenue led our growth, surging by 84% year over year. Meanwhile, our advertising business maintained its strong performance in the third quarter, recording a 28% year over year increase. The increasing top-line contribution from our high-margin games and advertising business propelled our gross profit up by 76% year-over-year, driving our gross profit margin jump to 34.9% from 25.0% in the same period last year. As a result, we successfully exceeded our commitment to reaching break-even in the third quarter, achieving an adjusted operating profit of RMB 272 million, and an adjusted net profit of RMB 236 million. While making remarkable financial progress, we continue to grow and cultivate our community. Both DAUs and MAUs reached record highs in the third quarter, hitting 107 million and 348 million, respectively. Meanwhile, the average daily time spent per user rose to a new high of 106 minutes. With robust user retention and engagement, our users have stayed with us and grown with the platform. The average age of Bilibili users is now 25. As these users enter new life stages with increasing spending power, we will continue to curate more diverse content and services that cater to their evolving needs. Moving ahead, we remain committed to building a welcoming and inspiring video community with all the videos you like. Our turn to profitability marks a new starting point in our journey. We will continue to invest in key infrastructure that supports content creation and distribution, reinforcing our leading position in the high-quality video content space and creating value for all our stakeholders. With that overview, let's look at our core content, community, and commercialization pillars in more detail. Beginning with content and community. In the third quarter, our average daily video views exceeded 5.7 billion, up 23% year over year. The growth reflects the effectiveness of our strategy to broaden content categories and encourage high-quality content creation. While our leading categories maintained their popularity, consumption-related categories continued rising. This is being driven by increasing user demand as the young generation becomes the mainstream of consumer society. Video views in fashion and home appliances and decoration grew by over 25% year over year, while views in automotive, baby and maternity, sports and fitness categories surged by more than 40% compared with the same period last year. The diverse commercialization channels we offer continue to empower our content creators to realize their commercial value while pursuing what they love. For the first 9 months of 2024, nearly 2.7 million content creators received income through various channels on our platform. Content creators' total income through our various advertising and VAS products grew by 24% during this period. Notably, content creators' total income through our fan charging product saw an over 400% increase year over year in the same period. Turning to our community metrics, in the third quarter, our DIU spent nearly 106 minutes on our platform every day, compared with 100 minutes in the same period last year. Our monthly interactions surpassed 19.3 billion, marking a 14% year-over-year increase. By the end of Q3, our official members grew to 251 million, with our 12-month retention rate remaining around 80%. Additionally, our sponsored esports team, Bilibili Game, BLG, fought their way to second place in the League of Legends S14 World Championship, marking a new record in the team's history. We are proud of their achievement and look forward to their continued success in the upcoming year. Events like these continue to support our leadership in the game community and make Bilibili the top choice for young generations. Last but not least, we are excited to share that our MSCI ESG rating was upgraded to an A this year, a testament to our steady ESG improvements over the past few years. This achievement underscores our dedication to advancing our ESG practices, where we use our influence to impact communities and society positively. Now, I'd like to talk about the progress of our commercialization in each of our business lines. First, on our games business. In the third quarter, our games revenues increased by 84% year over year to RMB 1.8 billion, driven by the outstanding performance of our strategy game, 三国谋定天下三谋. The game's initial performance reinforces our confidence in the longevity of 三谋. We will continue to roll out new content updates and gameplay to deliver better gaming experiences to users. 三谋's success shows the vast potential that lies within our game community. We plan to leverage our unique game industry advantage to further explore other game opportunities in different genres. Meanwhile, we remain committed to bringing the best ACG titles to our users. Our legacy titles, FGO and Azure Lane, maintained their popularity as they celebrated their 8th and 7th year anniversaries, respectively. In addition, we launched the Japanese RPG game, Jujutsu Kaisen, Phantom Parade, 咒术回战, 幻影夜行 in overseas markets in November, which was well received. Turning to our advertising business. Our advertising business continued to outperform the industry in the third quarter. Advertising revenues increased by 28% year over year to RMB 2.1 billion. Robust revenue growth in our performance-based ads was the largest contributor, increasing nearly 50% year over year in the third quarter. We also achieved decent year-on-year growth in brand and native ad revenues, reinforcing our strength in integrated marketing capabilities. Our top five advertising industry verticals in the third quarter were games, e-commerce, digital products and home appliances, internet services, and automotive. As more and more e-commerce platforms recognize the commercial value of our unique young user base, they allocated larger advertising budgets to our platform. We saw a particular uptick over the summer vacation and back-to-school season, resulting in an 80% year-over-year surge in e-commerce advertising revenues. Meanwhile, we are also attracting more advertisers from emerging verticals. In the third quarter, ad revenues from education, baby and maternity, and travel and lodging all grew by over 100% year-over-year. In addition, we continue to enhance our ad infrastructure to improve efficiency, and we have seen early benefits from these efforts. For example, as we roll out a more user-friendly and effective ad placement system, the number of performance-based advertisers increased by over 40% year over year in the third quarter. We plan to further incorporate AI technologies into our smart ad delivery system and launch a series of tools for ad material creation with higher efficiency and lower costs. These initiatives are expected to attract and retain more advertisers on our platform. Turning to our VAS business, revenues from our VAS business increased by 9% year over year to RMB 2.8 billion in the third quarter. This quarter, we welcome the more users to join and enjoy our live broadcasting universe as we continued expanding our content offerings to meet their diverse interests. Simultaneously, we remain focused on refining our operations to ensure sustainable business growth while improving margins. Our premium membership program grew steadily year over year, reaching nearly 22 million members in the third quarter. Over 80% of these members are on annual subscription or auto-renewal packages. Additionally, other VAS products experienced rapid growth. Fan charging revenues surged by over 500% year over year during the quarter, demonstrating our users' strong willingness to pay for good content. As we celebrate our first quarter of profitability, I want to thank our dedicated team, our loyal user community, and our supportive partners and shareholders. Looking back over the past 15 years, we've made significant breakthroughs in our content offerings, expanded our user base, and developed diverse commercialization products. These efforts have helped us build a unique video community with a one-of-a-kind user experience in a competitive industry landscape. Turning profitable is just a new beginning. Building on this milestone, we will continue to reinforce our business's positive growth cycle to drive sustainable profits in the future. With that, I will turn the call over to Sam to share more financial details.
Thank you, Mr. Chen. Hello, everyone. This is Sam. I will now provide a brief overview of our financial results for the third quarter of 2024. For a closer look at our financial results, we encourage you to refer to our press release issued earlier today. As a reminder, all amounts are in RMB unless otherwise noted. In the third quarter, we greatly improved our financial profile. We accelerated our year-over-year revenue growth across our core businesses, continued expanding our margins, and turned profitable on a non-GAAP basis. Total revenues for the third quarter were RMB 7.3 billion, up 26% year-over-year. Our total revenue breakdown by revenue stream for Q3 was approximately 38% VAS, 29% advertising, 25% mobile games, and 8% from our IP derivatives and other businesses. Our cost of revenues increased by 9% year-over-year to RMB 4.8 billion in the third quarter, while gross profit rose 76% year-over-year to RMB 2.5 billion. Our gross profit margin reached 34.9% in Q3, up from 25% in the same period last year. The significant improvement in our gross profit and gross profit margin this quarter indicates the elasticity and potential of our business model. Our total operating expenses were up 2% year-over-year to RMB 2.6 billion in the third quarter. Sales and marketing expenses increased by 21% year-over-year to RMB 1.2 billion, mainly due to increased marketing expenses for our exclusively licensed games. G&A expenses were RMB 505 million, which was relatively flat year-over-year. R&D expenses were RMB 906 million, down 15% year-over-year due to a higher base of termination expenses for certain game projects in Q3 last year. Our adjusted operating profit and adjusted net profit turned positive at RMB 272 million and RMB 236 million, respectively, marking significant gains from year-over-year losses. Our adjusted net profit ratio in the third quarter was 3%, compared with an adjusted net loss ratio of 15% in the same period a year ago. Cash flow-wise, we generated RMB 2.2 billion in positive operating cash flow in the third quarter, and RMB 4.6 billion in positive operating cash flow in the first 9 months of the year. As of September 30, 2024, we had cash and cash equivalents, time deposits, and short-term investments of RMB 15.2 billion or US$2.2 billion. With a healthy cash balance, we announced a share repurchase program of up to $200 million for our securities for the next 24 months, showcasing our commitment to enhance shareholder returns in the long term. Thank you for your attention. We would now like to open the call to your questions. Operator, please go ahead.
Thank you. We will now begin the question and answer session. To ask a question during the session, you will need to press star 11 on your telephone. You will then hear an automated message advising your hand is raised. To withdraw your question, please press star 11 again. For the benefit of all participants on today's call, if you wish to ask your question to management in Chinese, please immediately repeat your question in English. The company will provide consecutive interpretation for management statement during the Q&A session. Please note that English interpretation is for convenience purposes only. In the case of any discrepancy, management statements in the original language will prevail. Once again, that's star 11 for question. We will now take our first question from the line of Lei Zhang from Bank of America Securities. Please go ahead, Lei.
Hi, 管理层晚上好，谢谢接受我的提问，然后也恭喜你强劲的业绩，然后也很 surprise， 瑞总第一次在 call 上讲了英文，然后讲得非常好，希望以后可以继续，然后我的问题可能是比较 high level 的，然后想请教一下，在我们这个就 break even 实现盈利之后，管理层对未来整体 B 站的战略是怎么思考的，尤其是在这个社区的增长和商业化的方面有哪些侧重点，然后我在我们整体的这个视频行业里面能如何继续加强我们的优势，谢谢。我自己翻译一下吧。Thanks management for taking my question and congrats on the strong results. Since that, you know, Ray don't speak English, in the call for the first time is very well and pretty, impressive. My question is really high level and I want to know management's strategic view on Bilibili after trading on break-even this quarter. What is our key focus in user and commercialization going forward and how to strengthen our positioning in the video industry? Yeah, thank you.
那个大家刚才听到的就是在那个 call 上的那一段英文发言啊，它不是我真人说的，它是那个 AI 生成的，就是它就是用我们自研的这个 index 大模型的这个 TTS， 然后就从我的那个视频讲话里面，它取了一段15秒的一段那个素材，然后最后生成了这段英文的这个语音。反正我第一次听到我是吓一跳，所以我就觉得这就是我本人说的啊，所以那个这个也充分证明了就是 AI 这个技术吧，就是在比如说在我们未来在 UP 主念这个脚本啊，然后包括在这个未来就有可能我们在 B 站上面做的一些这种实时互动方面，它是一定是有很好的应用潜力的。
So actually the English prepared remarks that was spoken by me was not really spoken by me. It's generated by AI. It's our self-developed proprietary index TTS model. That only use 15 seconds of my speech during one of the event and generated that English prepared remark. I was quite surprised when I first hear it. It was just sounded like me. And that shows the vast potential of the AI application could do for Bilibili, such as helping our content creators to make those narratives or engage better on a real time with their users. We are quite looking forward to further leverage that to our application.
本季度 B 站应该是首次实现了单季度的盈利啊。然后刚才那个我们发财报之后，也有挺多朋友给我发来贺信贺电 啊，当然在我看来，那个这肯定是 B 站的一个里程碑，但是更多的我认为它是一个自然的一个结果。我认为我们这两年的工作只是让盈利这一天更早的到达。
Indeed, this is marks our very first quarter of adjusted profitability. And just now I was receiving a lot of congratulations from friends and investors. But as a matter of fact, we do believe this is a natural outcome of the evolvement of our business model and expansion of the industry. And we just made it happen faster.
对，我在这里还是就是我在讲这个未来我们的这个发展战略之前，我还是想简单总结一下，就是 B 站就是能够做到盈利的一个逻辑。首先呢，就是我认为视频是一个巨大的一个市场啊，而且中国肯定也是全世界最大的视频单一的市场之一。然后视频同时它也是一个大生意，然后在这么一个大市场当中， B 站呢是那个在中国独一无二的在 PUGC 啊，在高质量内容在中长视频方面有用户心智的一个平台。
So before I get into futures, I would like to look back a little bit on where we stand right now and the logic that's driving our profitability. First of all, the industry that we are in, the video industry, is a very large market, and China itself is the largest standalone market, and video is a large business. And within that industry, Bilibili has built a very uniqueone-of-a-kind PUGV community in China video market, known for the high-quality video content, and we have secured that user mindset.
就在中国，你只要提起高质量的视频，你只要提起这个叫我们叫有才华的 UP 主，然后你只要提起这个中长视频，就是你提到这几个点，用户心目中第一个反映出来的品牌一定是 B 站，就没有其他的，他甚至想不起第二个品牌是什么。就是因为视频它是一个超级大的市场，它也是未来互联网媒介的主流，所以的话就是我认为这种高质量的这种心智是像金子一般珍贵。
So when we are thinking about what is the highestwhere to find highest quality of content, where to find talented content creator, what's the go-to destination for mid to longer length of videos? Bilibili is always the number one brand name that pops up, and you can barely think of number two in this market. And because video is such a large market,and video will serve as the main media platform for this outlet, the brand awareness, the user mindset that is as precious as gold.
我觉得在那个 4G 和宽带的普及差不多也有十年的时间了，在过去十年时间里面，视频行业它经过了很长一段时间的发展，就是我认为现在视频已经从过去的就是内容极度不足，叫供给极度不足，变成了现在我认为视频的供给已经越来越充分了，然后用户现在已经从他想看视频这个需求升级为他想看高质量的，他想看独特的这样的一个视频。所以呢，就是我认为就是现在的这个视频行业已经有了一个很明显的叫内容消费升级的这么一个趋势，然后在这个趋势上 B 站肯定是有最大的优势，因为我们本身在用户心目中代表的就是高质量，代表的就是兴趣，他感兴趣的，他喜欢的，独特的。
Well, as the adoption of 4G, 5G network, our market has evolved from lack of supply of video content to enough supply of video content. And from users' perspective, they have evolved from wanting to look at any video to wanting to look at high quality video, unique video.So in some extent, we are experiencing an upgrade in content consumption in terms of video market. And riding on that trend, Bilibili has unique advantage because we have that user mindset and the brand awareness about that, those high quality unique content.
而且我们是在中国的90后00后就是所谓的 Z 世代当中叫密集度就是这个密度最高的这么一个视频平台吧。然后在过去的15年我们的用户留存非常好，他们一步一步的和 B 站成长起来。目前我们平台上的用户的平均年龄已经到达了25岁，就是这一个岁数它也让用户的这个商业价值不断的在提升。所以的话就是就我们可以看到，就是正因为我刚才所说的这一系列的一个原因，然后就是我们在商业上的发展它一定是加速的，盈利是一个必然的结果。而且的话我们如果看以后就是在商业上的一个潜力会被进一步的释放出来。
As we know that Bilibili has the highest density of Gen Z plus cohort, the 90s, the 2000 generation. And because we have very high sticky user cohort and user retention rate over the past 13 years, our user has stayed and grown with us. And the average age of Bilibili now has come to 25 years. So 25 also means their commercial value is increasing every day. That's why we see this is an inevitable trend that our commercialization will accelerate. And it's a natural outcome of reaching profitability. And going forward, we think there's vast potential for our commercialization to be unleashed.
对，然后讲一讲未来的一个那个具体的一个规划。在之前我也不断在强调，就是那个 B 站就是两个工作嘛，就是做好那个社区的这个用户增长和商业增长。然后我们在这个季度达到盈利之后，未来也会是这两个。那个工作是我们最重要的一个工作。
And in the future, in the past, we have stated our focus will be focusing on community growth and commercial growth. After reaching the profitability, our focus will remain unchanged.
然后在商业上的话，我就讲两点吧。第一呢，就是我们会更加的聚焦在我们的核心的业务上。比如说广告和游戏，因为这些核心的这个业务它拥有更高的收入的天花板，也有着更高的一个毛利，所以呢就是我们聚焦在这些工作上能够让我们的商业增长更有效率。
On commercialization, I'll share one thing that is will remain even more focused on the core business such as games and advertising.Because for those two business segments, they have higher market TAM, and by its nature, it has higher gross margin, and that will result more efficiency in terms of our commercialization growth.
然后第二点呢，就是我们会始终重视用商业去反哺我们的内容生态，然后就形成我们。那个内容就是相当于是它是一个更好的内容增长和商业增长的一个那种正反馈的一个闭环吧。然后我们其实在过去不断的在引导那个通过商业的一个方式帮助 UP 主去提升收入。在今年的前九个月呢就有近270万名 UP 主在 B 站获得收入。所以呢就是那个我们认为商业的增长也能够让我们这些 UP 主获益，让他们更具备创作优质内容的积极性。
And the success of our commercialization will also support the prosperity of our content ecosystem. And we have been pursuing that formation of the positive flywheel effect between content ecosystem and our commercialization growth.And as a matter of fact, in the first 9 months of this year, leveraging our various commercial outlets, 2.7 million content creators have received income on Bilibili platform. And those commercialization in one way is helping our content creator to realize their commercial value and hence motivate their further and more content creation.
对，因为我在这儿还可能会特别的指出一下，就是在 B 站这个平台上， 那个商业并不狭义的指广告，然后那个因为 B 站它是一个综合商业模型的这么一个平台，然后比如说对于 UP 主来说的话，就除了像广告商单带来的收入之外的话，像我们的充电，对，包括我们会去引导 UP 主去和用户建立一些更多元化的连接，比如说像绘画啊，像他们的这种手工能够在我们上面卖啊，啊，甚至他们开课啊等等的，然后这些我认为都是就是 B 站这边能够为这些创作者去做的事儿。
And one thing I wanted to emphasize that for Bilibili's commercialization outlets, it's more than just advertising because we are a comprehensive platform and we provide more tools beyond advertising to help them realize their commercial value, establishing connection between their followers. For example, on top of the native ads, Sparkle advertising platform, we have our fan charting program. We also have a craft studio, encourage content creators to monetize their skills such as handcraft and drawing, and also premium courses to help them make money in various ways.
然后最后呢，我想说就是我认为咱们这个 Q3 的盈利只是一个开始，接下来我觉得商业增长能够更好的去促进我们的内容生态的繁荣，然后形成一个正向的飞轮效应。我认为商业的成长它是能够让 B 站更健康更持续的发展。
The profitability in Q3 is just a beginning and we look forward to form a positive flywheel effect formed by our content ecosystem and commercialization growth.And the growth of our commercialization will, in fact, help Bilibili to become an even healthier organization and achieve sustainable, profitable growth. Next question, please, operator.
Thank you. Our next question comes from the line of Daniel Chen from JP Morgan. Please ask your question, Daniel.
谢谢给我这个机会问问题哈，我这个问题是关于这个广告的，想请问一下这个三季度这个广告增长的驱动力，因为我们增速达到了接近30%哈，是非常强劲。然后四季度呢有没有观察到广告宏观需求的变化？另外也想请教一下我们双十一期间的这些带货这个表现哈，谢谢。So my question is on advertising, which is very strong. We have grown 28% year over year in the third quarter. So what's the key driver behind the third quarter advertising growth? And also for the fourth quarter, do we see there is a change in the kind of a macro environment for the advertising demand? And also lastly, how is our performance in the Double 11?Festival for our e-commerce related business. Thank you.
谢谢你的问题啊，就是在 B 站 Q3 的广告收入20.9亿吧，就确实保持了28%接近30%的一个高速增长。其中的话，效果类型的广告的增速更快一些，应该接近了50%。对毛利，对整个公司的毛利的提升也比较正向的一个驱动的结果吧。
So Bilibili's Q3 advertising revenue indeed was a good performance. It reached close to 2.1 billion RMB and maintained a strong growth rate of 28%. And behind that, performance-based ads grow nearly 50%. And this is helping us driving our gross margin and on a group level.
就 Q3 的话，我们还是延续去年一贯的这个一恒安众的一个策略吧。在具体来说 Q3 有什么样的一个变化，也可以在这里分享一下。就其中的一恒，我们往往指的就是平台的基建的方面。就第一个部分，其实还是在我们还是极其的重视 B 站的社区的用户体验的，但我们又要做到足够的释放更多的广告库存，那怎么做呢？我们还是坚持了这个多屏多场景的策略。商业库存我们可以看到在首页的信息流包括 story mode 这种方式上可以快速得到增长以外， 最近一两个 Q 能看到在相关推荐搜索甚至 PC 跟 Pad 这端口里面也贡献了比以往更多的一些广告收入。其实值得比较期待的，或许在后面我们会通过直播场景播放器内的场景、热搜等更多的场景，也会有更多的广告的征收空间。那除此以外的话，此前我们也反复提到，就是我们尝试的在自然跟商业流量上进行混排，就让原生化的广告除了这个商业流量以外，可以得到更多的自然流量，同时就实现内容即广告、广告即内容的一个场景。现在的话呢，也因此收到了比较好的一个有效的库存吧，这是第一个部分。
In Q3, we continued our Yihen Enzone strategy. To be more specific on Yihen, that was more referring to the platform infrastructure construction. On first point, we released more ad inventory while emphasizing on maintaining a good user experience. By maintaining a multi-screen, multi-scenario strategy,commercial inventory grow rapidly on our homepage feed and story mode, and also generated increased ad revenue across recommendations, search, PC, and even tablet platform in recent one to two quarters. Looking forward, there's more potential for additional revenue from live streaming, video within video players, and also hot topic search. And on top of that, through a blend of organic and commercial traffic and native ad integration, more high quality ads received more distribution, effectively expanding our ad inventory. At the same time, we have achieved content is a good commercial, and good commercial is a good content effect.
在第二点的这个基建建设上的话，我们还进一步的优化了投放的链路。举个例子啊，就通过移动端的整个智能投放的设置的话，客户数同比已经增长了有7倍。未来的话呢，我们也将会继续的帮助整体的广告主降低投放的门槛。另外一组数据也可以看到的，我们把花火跟广告系统打通之后，在广告投放花火的商单的比例是持续提升的。在 Q3 的话已经接近了 60%、做商单的同时必然投我们的效果广告，所以深度证明了将花火加起飞的广告模式的成立。
The second point is that we further optimized our ad placement system. In the third quarter, the number of clients in mobile smart ad placement increased by 700% year-on-year.We will continue to improve our products and tools to make ad placement easier. Another example would be with the integration of Sparkle and our ad system, the proportion of Sparkle ads that engaged in ad promotion reached nearly 60% in Q3, further demonstrating the effectiveness of our Sparkle Plus 起飞 aka ad promotion services model.
第三点就是我们也上线了这个创意中心跟 AI 机器生成了这个内容的功能，现在的话还是初步得到了一些成效吧，未来的话我会进一步推出更多 AI 机器的工具，可以帮助广告主自动生成或者修改大量的内容广告素材，就进一步的去达到这个降门槛降成本，这也是很关键的。所以 Q4 的话我们也会持续的去优化刚才提到的一些基础建设，也会提升算法的效率，也是会因此应该会更有信心的去让更多新的广告主进入 B 站的整个社区氛围，成为我们的内容创作者，也成为我们的广告客户。
The third point would be the launch of Creative Center and AIGC auto generated content has also improved our ad efficiency.We plan to roll out additional AIGC tools to help advertisers automatically create or modify ad materials, further lowering their cost and barriers. And in Q4, we'll continue to enhancing our ad placement experience, improving algorithm efficiency, and we wanted to attract more new advertiser to Bilibili to create content to connect with our users.
刚才提到的 Anzhong 就是指垂直行业的解决方案，在 Q3 的前五大广告主主要来于游戏、电商、数码家电、网服以及我们的汽车。就是在这些优势行业持续能保持比较大的预算以外，我们还能看到在游戏行业里面，除了我们比较擅长的一些游戏类目， Q3 小游戏日均的投放环比还是提升了 200% 的，包括也在数码家电行业，在发新品这个场景里面吸引了像 Apple、 华为、 Vivo 等科技品牌都会在 B 站上进行首发。Q3 还有一个点啊，就是我们还是抓住了非大触节点的电商广告，就是来自于行业型的广告同比增长也接近 80%。 历史上我们都会在双十一啊、618、双十二大节点带来新的涨幅，但这一次在非大节点也拿到了比较大的一个涨幅，也可以看到就是确实对钱最敏感的平台也能知道在什么节点去投放广告，可以进一步的看到就是 B 站平台的广告价值吧。所以在巩固我们这个优势品类的同时，我们还是会积极的探索更多新的品类的。在 Q3 除了刚才提到的优势品类以外，像教育啊、母婴啊、文旅啊等等的行业都实现了比较大的高速增长吧。
And the end zone refers to the industry vertical ad solutions, and the top five ad verticals in Q3 coming from number one games, number two e-commerce, digital products, and online services, number five is automotive. In this leading verticals that we have clear advantage, we continue to expand our market share.And one example on game sectors, apart from our experience genre in the sector, daily app placements for mini games sector increased by 200% quarter over quarter. In digital products and home appliances, we attract top tech brands like Apple, Huawei, and Vivo to launch their new products on Bilibili. In Q3, we capturedmore advertising brands during non-shopping festival periods with e-commerce ad revenue up nearly 80% year over year. Traditionally, we see e-commerce platforms to place more ads in the big shopping festival seasons, but in Q3, we're actually attracting more advertising budget during the summer vacation and the back to school seasons, reflecting the high value of our high-quality young audiences. And for those brand advertisers, for those e-commerce players, they saw the value in our platform as well as in our users. And while strengthening our advantageous categories, advertisers from more industries are choosing Bilibili. In Q3, sectors like education, baby and maternity, travel and lodging, etc., have already achieved high growth and will continue to expand to more industry verticals.
在今年的双十一的结果也可以分享一下， B 站还是坚持带开环的策略的，所以我们成为了阿里、京东、拼多多、唯品会等电商平台的深度合作伙伴吧。带货的 GMV 我们同比增长了超过 150%，带货的 UP 主同比也增长了接近 80%， 79%， 就 B 站为全部行业，就我们所服务的行业带来的新客率都超过了 50%， 其中也包括 3C 数码、家具家装啊、美妆服饰啊、母婴啊等等的行业，其实我们都成为了电商平台获新客的主要重要来源吧。所以因此的话，双十一期间也直接带给 B 站的广告收入同比增长有接近 50%。
For the Double 11, we maintained our open loop strategy, become a deep trusted partner for e-commerce platforms like Alibaba, Jingdong, Pinduoduo, and VIP shops.
GMVs from video and live e-commerce increased over 150% year-on-year, and participating content creators rose by 80%. Among the customers we bring to those merchant shops, new customer rates exceeded on average 50% across all sectors, including 3C and digital products, home decor, beauty, and baby and maternity, etc. We have become the key source for new customers across all e-commerce platforms. And this also helped us to achieve a close to 50% year-on-year increase in ad revenue during the Double 11 period.
刚才也提到宏观经济的环境，我们的观察从客户预算的投放其实依然是存在确实存在不确定性的，就不同的行业可能会呈现出不同的情况吧，就例如我们看到国补的政策以旧换新，就会带动 3C 数码家具家电还是比较强势的恢复在预算侧，但另外我们也同时能看到像食品饮料医疗包括教育等行业会慢慢的恢复这个市场信心吧，相对会慢一些。那同时看到像汽车美妆鞋服房地产这些预算依然收的还是很紧的。我们判断短期的话根据不同的行业还是会有差异，而且存在波动性的，就此起彼伏。但从中长期来看的话，我们对国内的经济还是特别乐观跟有信心的吧。
You mentioned asked about the macro environment, how does that bring changes to the advertising industry? Well, from our perspective, under the current macro environment, there are still some uncertainties in the advertisers' budget.But the condition varies by industry, different industries. For example, sectors supported by the national subsidy policies, such as the digital products and home appliances, are seeing a strong recovery. And on food and beverage, healthcare, and education are beginning to regain market confidence in a more gradual way. While the budget remains tight,in sectors such as automotive, beauty and fashion, and real estate. Even though we expect short-term fluctuations across different industries, we remain optimistic and confident about the domestic economy in the mid to long term.
那最终的和回归 B 站来看，我们还是特别有信心在 Q4 可以持续的超过行业的增速的。收入规模应该在全行业也会的收入占比吧也会进一步得到提升谢谢。
Going back to Bilibili's advertising revenue, we remain confident that we can maintain a faster than industry average growth rate for our advertising revenue in Q4 and further increasing our shares in this, across all various industry verticals.That concludes Kawi's answers. Thank you. And operator, next question, please.
Thank you. Next question comes from the line of Yang Liu from Morgan Stanley. Please ask your question, Yang.
非常感谢提问的机会。首先先恭喜公司在这个季度实现了盈利。那我的问题是关于游戏的。那这个季度游戏业务表现非常的亮眼 ,80% 多的收入增长。那我想多问一下最重点的游戏三谋表现如何，然后后续有什么样的运营的规划，那如何公司会怎么考虑未来三谋的用户获取的力度和节奏，然后也想请管理层更新一下未来游戏的这个新游戏的 pipeline 和品类的规划。Let me translate my question. My question is about the game business, which grows more than 80% in the third quarter. My question is about the Sanmo's performance and what is outlook and the operation planning in future for this game. And also, would like to hear management thoughts on user acquisition and also the user acquisition for this game, and also the future pipeline in Bilibili's game business, and also the potential new genres in future. Thank you.
三谋的话现在已经是进展到第三个赛季吧，即将开始第四个赛季。就从前三个赛季的表现来看的话，确实应该是就是在国内吧，就是今年那个表现最好的游戏之一。我们多次应该是冲到了那个 App Store 畅销榜的前三名。
The game 三国谋定天下now has entered in the stage of game season 3, and we're about to enter into game season 4. So based on what we've seen so far, we can proudly say that Sanmo is one of the best performing games in the China gaming market this year.
就除了这个就是短期的这个业绩表现，其实我个人更重视的是Sanmo的长线运营的一个节奏。我内部对团队也说，就是三谋最重要的目标就是实现长线运营，就是我口中这个长线运营指的是至少五年生命周期的一个稳定运营。
Besides the short-term performances, what I care the most is the longevity and sustainable operation of Sanmo. And when I say longevity and long-term operation, I'm referring to at least five to ten years.
对，因为我这个长线运营的这个目标是在游戏研发阶段就提给团队的，所以呢，我们在游戏的设计和运营思路上都为长线运营是做了充分的规划和准备。所以这个所以的话，就从我们那个前三个季度来看，三谋的用户活跃还有留存都应该是在行业前列的，因为这个用户活跃和留存就是我们做长线运营的一个前提嘛。
And to achieve the goal of long-term operation, we have made extensive plans in initial R&D phases and preparation in terms of the game design and operation strategy. Based on the performance of the first three seasons, we can say that the user engagement level and retention rates among the highest in this genre in the industry.
就后天那个11月16号我们会开启三谋第四赛季的那个运营。第四赛季我们会推出全新的地图、武将还有剧本的玩法。应该说这个新赛季给用户的体验会是不错的。
And the day after tomorrow, November 16th, we will be launching the brand new game season 4.And in the new game season, we'll be featuring a new map, characters, and new storyline gameplay. And we are quite confident that with the new version content update, will provide users with even more engaging and fun gaming experience.
对，大家应该都可以看到，就是在三谋里面，我们其实是相对于同行吧，我们是做了不少的。创新和差异化的，这些创新和差异化都是来自于就是用户的一个反馈，就是我们收集行业里面用户的反馈。而且呢，就是从我们的封测到那个第三赛季吧，我们也是会频繁的去找用户，以及认真的去倾听用户的意见。反正玩家应该是把我们团队称为就是行业里面最听玩家劝的团队吧。所以呢，就是我们其实在前三个季度也是收集了挺多玩家的一些意见，然后这些意见我们应该在内部是充分重视的，然后我们也根据这些意见去做我们即将开启的 S4 包括后面 S5 的这个赛季的一些改进。
And many of you might know that the Sanmo has done a lot of innovation and differentiation compared to the similar genres games. The reason behind that is from day one, we have collected many, many users' feedback from our close beta testing to the latest season 3. We have welcome feedback and actively engage with our users to listen to their advice and make adjustments based on their feedback. And we also got the reputation of the best game company that listens to the user's feedback. And based on those user feedback, we have proactively adjusted within our new brand, new season four, and going forward, the following seasons, we will continue to listen to our user and optimize, improve our games to give them best experience.
刚才我提到长线运营，所以的话，那个明年我们整个游戏业务最重要的这个工作之一，也就是把三谋明年运营好。我们在策略游戏这一个赛道上，我们很长阶段就会只做这一款游戏吧，然后把这款游戏真正的做到位，因为我认为这款游戏的天花板足够的高。然后我们的整个的运营发行团队还是挺精英化的，那个我们也会聚焦在把这款游戏真正做好，就是能够做出一条上扬的一条曲线。然后同时的话，那个我们也会准备在明年下半年就是发行这款游戏的海外的繁体版，然后同时也是就是聚焦在这一款游戏，放大这个游戏的这个用户量吧，把它发到全世界其他国家去。
And when I say the longevity of this game, that is my next year goal, is the top priority will be continue to optimize Sunmo's user experience and user engagement.And for this particular strategy game genre, we'll be very focused on this one single title. And because we also have a big team of developers and operators, we will be really focusing our best resources on optimizing this game. And in the second half of this year, we will be starting to preparing for the international launch of Sunmo, starting with the traditional Chinese version.And we also look forward to bring this high quality strategy game to the users worldwide.
说一下那个就是三谋之外的那个工作吧，就是刚才我提到就是三谋它本身是一个新的赛道嘛，它是 SLG 游戏，然后那个就是它的出现是我们内部讲的叫品类年轻化的一个结果。所以呢，就是除了二次元和 SLG 这两个我们已经做了的赛道之外的话，就是我们在明年还会尝试一个新的赛道，然后在这个赛道上去尝试品类年轻化的一个方法，就这个是我们那个接下来在那个游戏方面要做的那个工作之一吧，就明年。
And the success of Sunmo is a testament.To the strategy of reinventing games for young generations. And we have succeeded in the strategy genre. And on top of the strategy and the ACG genre, next year we'll be looking to explore a new genre and adapting our methodology of reinventing games for young generations to this new genre.And hopefully can bring another new pie to the Bilibili game.
对，第二个呢，就是在那个二次元游戏方面，大家应该已经注意到，就是11月7日嘛，那个我们在海外是发了《咒术回战》，这个也是我们第一次吧，就是在海外，除了日本之外的所有的国家，然后发一款游戏，然后。目前玩家的反馈是不错的，我们在70多个国家和地区是拿了下载榜的第一名，而且呢，就是从目前来看，运营的一个状况也在我们的一个预期之内。这个算是我们就是叫通发全球吧的一次尝试。我认为《咒术回战》也是那个就是包括我们在明年比较重要的一款游戏吧。
And in terms of the ACG genre, many of you might noticed, we have successfully launched the Jujutsu Kaisen, the international version, globally except Japan and China, on November 7th. And so far, we have achieved very good results. The game reached top downloading charts number 1 in more than 70 countries and regions. And so far, the user feedback has been very positive. This marks a very successful attempt at our very first global distribution of ACG games. And for this particular game in 2025, it will also be one of our important games to sustain and propel.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Next question, please.
Thank you. Our next question comes from the line of Felix Liu from UBS. Please ask your question, Felix.
谢谢管理层接受我的提问，也恭喜我们公司今年这个季度第一次盈利。那我想问一些关于财务的问题。我们公司这次盈利之后，想请问一下我们接下来毛利以及净利率的展望。另外我也关注到我们公司这一次 announce 了2亿美金的回购，这个也是非常好的一个这个进展。那想问一下我们接下来股东回报的这个计划会怎么样去思考。Thank you management for taking my question. Congratulations on turning profitable this quarter. My question is more on the financial side. So what is your GP margin and the profit margin outlook after you're successfully turning profitable this year, this quarter? And also we noticed that you announced a new share repurchase program. So how should we think about your shareholder reward scheme going forward? Thank you.
This is Sam. I will take your question. In Q3, we not only met our previous committed break-even goal, but also exceeded by achieving an adjusted profit of 270 million RMB. This result demonstrates the potential of our business model. Our revenue in Q3 grew by 26% when gross profit saw a significant year-over-year increase of 76%, with the gross profit margin rise nearly 10 points from 25 to close to 35%. This improvement was mainly due to the increased of share of the high margin game and advertising revenue, along with the effective control of our, fixed cost. We believe that with the continued growth of our advertising and gaming business, there is a further room for long-term improvement in our gross profit margin. Additionally, it's worth mentioning that our operating cash flow reached 2.2 billion RMB in Q3, with the operating cash flow for the first three quarters reaching 4.6 billion RMB. This indicates that our business has entered a healthy positive cycle. That's also the background that why we announced in our financial report $200 million repurchase plan to be carried out over the next 24 months to increase our return to our shareholders. Looking ahead to Q4, if you look at our deferred revenue balance, that balance in the end of Q3 increased by 380 million RMB quarter over quarter, laying a solid foundation for Q4. So we expect the revenue from gaming and advertising business to maintain a strong growth momentum with further quarter over quarter improvements in gross profit margin and deliver further improved non-GAAP operating income. That's it.
For your next question, please.
Thank you. We will now take our last question from the line of Lincoln Kong from Goldman Sachs. Please ask your question, Lincoln.
哎，谢谢管理层啊，这是我的提问呢。那我的问题是可能宏观一点啊，我们从九月底也看到整个一个大的这个宏观方面的一些转向和陆续的这些刺激政策的出台。那从B 站这边的这个业务层面的角度，我们现在有没有看到一些边际上的变好或者继续加速的这样的一些情况，无论是广告啊、游戏啊、直播，还是用户的付费意愿这边。So thank you management for taking my question. My question is about more the macro policy. Since end of September, we have seen quite a bit shift in terms of those policy and the more stimulus coming. So from the company's business level, have we seen any incremental better trends in terms of advertising, gaming, live streaming, or user paying propensity? Thank you.
我们从企业的角度是很高兴看到这些积极的经济政策的出台的， 我认为这些政策本身就是很好的信号，它代表政府对经济的重视，而且的话那个我们也在近期切身的感受到政府对民营企业的关注，还有优化营商环境的决心。
From a business perspective, we are very pleased to see a series of positive economic policy being introduced. We view this policy as highly encouraging signals that reflect the government's commitment to economic growth. And recently, we also felt we felt the government's attention to private sectors and its determination to improve the business environment ourselves.
对，当然我们也应该知道，就是从这个政策的提出到它落地产生实际效果，肯定是需要时间的。但我觉得那个方向如果已经确定了，就是要真正的搞好经济的这个方向的话，我认为这个时间的问题还好。
While some of these policies are still in the pipeline and might take time for their effects to materialize, but we think it's just simply a matter of time as the overall direction has been set and clear.
对，因为 B 站属于是那个互联网平台经济的这么一个生态位嘛，就是互联网平台经济应该是整个国家经济的一个组成部分。如果国家整体的这个经济形势向好， B 站一定是在其中的一个受益者。
Well, Bilibili is part of the platform economy, and the platform economy is a key part of a broader economy in China. So when the overall economy improves, Bilibili will undoubtedly benefit from that improvement.
对，当然因为我们做企业嘛，所以的话那个就是我们能做的工作就是把自身做好。我觉得宏观经济肯定是一个那个叫加成，就是如果我们自身做好，宏观经济也好，那么它就是好上加好。但是我们在做的所有的规划包括我们对未来的这么一个那个预期，我们是没有考虑到那个就是宏观经济的这个变好的。就变得更好的这个因素的，就是我们就是考虑就是在一个就是没有外界因素的情况下，我们能做的什么样，我们是按照这个来做计划的。
Well, of course, as a company, we will be paying more attention to our own development, specifically on the path to achieve company and profitability growth, commercial growth.We are planning for our next year and the year afterwards, we wouldn't factor in the overall economy will improve drastically. We'll be focusing on what we can do to improve our own business model, to improve our product, to give better content to our users.
B 站一贯的风格都是我们是重视长期的一个健康发展，而且的话大家应该看到就是我们的用户也都主要是一个年轻的一个用户，所以的话我还是很期待就是看到就是未来就是在这一系列的这个政策起到作用之后就是 B 站能够有更好的一个表现。
Well, Bilibili has always been known for focusing on the long-term sustainable healthy development, and because our users are also the young generation,So I'm very much looking forward to the landing of those stimulation policies that can bring the company, the user, and the society to a better future. Thank you. Operator, that concludes today's call. Thank you.
Thank you. And that concludes the question and answer session. Thank you once again for joining Bilibili's third quarter 2024 financial results and business update conference call today.If you have any further questions, please contact Juliet Yang, Bilibili's Executive IR Director, or Pichante Financial Communications. Contact information for IR in both China and the U.S. can be found on today's press release. Thank you and have a great day.